Blessings, friends of the border town. It's Father Pete Jankowski as I blatantly violate the sixth chapter of Matthew's gospel because so many friends on our online services wanted to have videos concerning those in our parish who are living the faith. One of the questions I had asked those in our communities, young and old, is what they are going to do during this Lenten season. What are they going to sacrifice? What are they going to do more to reflect the life of Christ? Prayer, fasting, and almsgiving are the three charisms that the sixth chapter of Matthew's gospel tell us to live if we want to get to heaven. It also tells us to do it in secret, which I am violating by having our friends in the community tell us what they're going to do this Lent to remind us how this small sacrifice leads to the much greater sacrifice on the altar. So for your edification and enjoyment, I offer you a 5-minute video of friends from the border town and surrounding areas who are going to share with us their experiences and their sacrifices during this Lenten season. What are you giving up?
I'm going to give up watching HGTV.
You're going to watch HGTV?
I'm going to give it up.
Why are you giving up HGTV?
Because I like it a lot, and that's a big penance.
What is HGTV?
Well, I'm pretty much going to focus more on, like, a praying.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of things are you going to pray?
Like, for sinners.
I thought I was going to have...
Pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And what are you guys going to give up for Lent? You're going to give up candy? What kind of candy are you going to give up?
I'm going to give up Snicker bars.
You're going to give up Snicker bars?
I'm going to give up every kind of candy.
You're going to give up every kind of candy. So every time you see a candy bar, you got to say, I love Jesus. How do you like that?
Yep. I said I'm giving up rutabaga, Brussels sprouts, and liver.
Rutabaga, Brussels sprouts, and liver. All the things that are good for you. What a life that John Raymer is living. And he's our director of religious ed. He's giving rutabaga, Brussels sprouts, and liver.
I considered it. I'm thinking maybe my Sunday morning donuts.
Your Sunday morning donuts?
Yes.
Ben Affleck loves Dunkin' Donuts.
Yes.
Why don't we get you and Ben Affleck to give up Dunkin' Donuts for Lent? That's right.
Enojarme.
No. Pero tú deseas no estar enojado a la gente. Siempre. Pero los niños necesitan escuchar su madre más durante la cuaresma, ¿sí? Flojos.
Me? Pretty much snacks between meals. I'm trying to cut back on the meals, too. I'm also thinking of around Friday, strictly going for bread, water, and butter. And, of course, cutting back on a lot of entertainment. Including the internet.
Lenten season, and why
actually,
are you...
I am increasing my prayer life by adding one day to Adoration Chapel and also going to Mass on Saturday as well.
And wisdom to bring Christ's love to others, especially those not practicing the faith during this Lenten season.
So how are you going to do that?
Well, I'm going to daily Mass, and as I meet people in their daily lives, especially those that I know are not practicing the faith, that I have the grace and wisdom to give them words of encouragement to bring them back to
for St. Joseph and Juliet. What are you going to sacrifice for Lent?
I'm going to try to make Mass every morning during Lent, because when I do make Mass in the morning, the whole day goes easier.
And that is a way of
doing. I am giving up pop.
Soda popcorn?
Pop.
Soda pop.
Soda pop. Yes.
What kind of soda do you drink?
Pepsi. All the time. Too much.
Too much Pepsi product. So whenever you see a Pepsi product and you have to sacrifice it,
yes.
What is that going to make you remind yourself of?
To do better for myself.
Better for yourself and to live like Christ in your small little sacrifice pales in comparison to the huge sacrifice on the cross.
That is true.
Dorothy, would you agree with that?
Yes.
Thank you, Dorothy.
You know why? Because I carry a cross.
Come here, Dorothy.
Okay. Carry a cross.
Yes.
Okay.
And I have a little rosary, so I will pray for each day that we put forth the effort to make the decision dates with God.
Amen to both of you. And we finally got Dorothy in the video.
I want to do more for others.
Like what?
Be there when somebody asks for help. And take care of my family as much as I possibly could. And do whatever I could for the church.
What about that one?
I'm not going to snack during meals like I do all the time. And I don't eat candy. Well, potato chips, candy. I eat a lot of candy.
You like
what do you say he's going to give up for Lent?
He's going to give up.
He's going to take time. He's going to give up time to pray for Jesus. Because Dominic is like the smartest, holiest person in the whole church. Right, Dominic? You want to be a priest when you grow up? Yeah.
Hey, Gabby, what are you going to give up for Lent? Are you going to give up begging for food at the table? Are you going to be nice to Father Pete? Are you just going to keep howling for food? Are you going to be a... Oh, my goodness gracious. Look at her go.